For question number 7, the answer is 6.30 up to 2 decimal places, 6.30 meter, as we shall see while solving the problem. To show steps of solution, in step 1, we apply the impulse momentum theorem to find out the speed of the block immediately after the impulse is given. So, by impulse momentum theorem, we can write down that the impulse given to the block, that is I, is equal to the change in its linear momentum, that is delta P. The final value of momentum, P2, minus initial value of momentum, that is P1. But since the mass of the block is M, we can write P2 as M into V and P1 as M into U. Remember, this is U is the speed of this block just before the impulse given, that was zero because the block was at rest initially, and V is the speed acquired by the block just after the impulse is given. Putting the data, I is given to be 1.0 Newton second, this equal to mass that is given 0.4 kg for the block. V is unknown, and the second term A mu vanishes because U is zero. So from here, when you solve, you are finding this V to be 1 by 0.4, that is 2.5 meter per second. And this is nothing but the speed acquired by the block just after the impulse. They have called it V0 in this problem. So we shall call it V0 now. That is step number 1. In step 2, we note that instantaneous velocity V of the block is a function of time given by V0 into e to the power minus t by tau. Well, of course, V0 is the speed at time t is equal to 0. Tau is a constant appearing in the power of exponential function, that is Euler's number e, right? So since we are looking for the displacement of this block in a given time, we shall write this velocity as dx dt in derivative form. That is the rate of change in the x coordinate with time. As they have said, the block moves along the x axis. Here dx dt is the rate of change in x coordinate with time. So dx dt is this, and therefore we could write down dx is equal to v dt, that is V0 into e to the power minus t by tau into dt. There are two variables here, differential equations. So let us integrate that in the next step. Both sides, left hand side integration of dx between the limits x0 and x. X0 is the position of the block at time t is equal to 0, x is at any time, say tau. On the right hand side, integrating v0 into e to the power minus t by tau dt. And if you read the question, they're looking for the displacement in time equal to tau. So initial time is 0, final time is tau. As you integrate, left-hand side coming out to be simply x minus x0. That is nothing but the displacement we are looking for. So delta x is equal to x minus x0. And this is v0 is a constant taken outside into integration of e to the power minus t by tau dt between the limits 0 to tau. Is that clear? We call it equation number 1. For future reference. Well, since the value of V0 is already calculated here and tau is given to be 4 seconds, there is not much physics left. What is left is a bit of integration. So I shall draw a margin on the right side and show my step 3 here, that is integrating this right hand side of equation number 1. I'm taking this part only. Let me write that. We define an indefinite integral as I is equal to this. I, don't confuse that with this I used earlier for impulse. So this is an integration I. So this integral I is equal to e to the power minus t by tau dt. Okay, now how do we evaluate it? Let us put a new variable z is equal to minus t by tau, so that dz dt becomes 1 by tau, and we can express dt is equal to minus tau into dz. Returning here, we can write now I is equal to minus tau under integral sign e to the power z dz, isn't it? If I put dt is equal to minus tau dz, minus tau is taken outside, the constant, integration of e to the power z dz, and this is giving me simply minus tau into e to the power z. We can write finally I is equal to minus tau into e to the power, what was z? Minus t by tau. That is the indefinite integral here. So once we get this, let us evaluate this definite integral. We can write between the limits 0 and tau e to the power minus t by tau dt. We already got this result, indefinite integral. So I'm keeping it inside square brackets, minus tau into e to the power minus t by tau, kept within square brackets, and the limits written outside. So putting upper limit first, we can write this is minus tau into e to the power minus 1, isn't it? When you put t is equal to tau, we are getting minus tau into e to the power minus tau upon tau, that is e to the power minus 1. And then putting lower limit, minus minus, that is plus tau into e to the power 0. When you put t is equal to 0, is coming out to e to the power 0 here. So what is that? This is minus tau upon e plus tau. If I take tau common, we have got 1 minus 1 upon e. In the question, they have given e to the power minus 1 to be 0.37. So, it's eventually coming out to be 0.63 into tau. So all these things I'm showing in step number 3, a bit of integration with a technique which I'm sure you are aware of, but I have practiced with you. So once we get the result, let us get back. This is if we call equation number 2 we got, that is the value of this definite integral. So going for the next step, step number 4, where you combine equations 1 and 2. What do we get? We are getting the displacement delta x in time tau, that is equal to v0 into this, that is from here, 0.63 tau, putting values now, v0 already found to be 2.5 meter per second into 0.63. into the value of tau that was given to be 4 seconds. We solve and show this coming out to be 6.8 0.30 meter, and that is the solution for this problem.